When central banks have hit the floor, they'll go lower. Negative rates have become the new normal, yet they are anything but. In the end, companies will make less and less profit. Corporations taking on more expenses from tariffs and taxes will ultimately pass this on to their consumers and will of course result in a slowing of the economy. The central banks will only have one option: print their currencies to confetti. You came here for the truth, so let me unveil that for you. Today I have a few topics to cover. First, I want to begin with the tariffs. New situations are unfolding. We are going to look at interest rates, particularly going into the negative, going to record lows all the time. I want to touch on Australia. I want to look at what's going on in the UK. I have a lot to discuss here, so let's begin right away. So it's not just China, we are seeing this happening now with Vietnam. The US Commerce Department imposed duties of more than 400% on steel imports from Vietnam, accusing some businesses of shipping products from the Southeast Asian nation to avoid levies in a further escalation of tensions between the two trading partners. This is not good right now. We do not need more tensions. We do not need a slowdown to be exacerbated by one thing or another, whether it's tariffs, whether it's taxes or regulation or maybe a dispute going on between them geopolitically. All I know is that this is not the right time. This type of event could take place when things are really booming in the economy. Now isn't that time. Right at the bottom here, you're seeing some information I thought was pretty true. It's not surprising companies will try to route products through countries such as Vietnam to dodge higher duties. It's a no-brainer. You increase the cost and people are going to try and find a way to avoid it. It's human nature. That's the way it goes. And this is what you are seeing today. It happens to be Vietnam, but now we have another one that might be added to the list. Australia successfully avoided the sudden imposition of US tariffs on steel and aluminum last year after an exemption, but the New York Times reported on June 2nd that US officials wanted the exemption on aluminum to be removed because the Australian exports had grown so quickly. So whether or not this actually goes into place, I wanted to bring it to you before that happens so we can see it all coming down the line. Speaking of Australia, interest rates at 1% may be new for Australia, but we're just following everyone else into the basement. I had multiple subscribers telling me about yet another interest rate decrease coming out of Australia, right now sitting at 1%, historically abnormally low. This is completely unheard of, and yet it happens to be going on not just in Australia, but just about everywhere. How can you tell me that things are doing just fine when we have historically low interest rates all the way around? You reduce interest rates when economies are slow. That is an absolute fact. Not just within the last 10 years. Look at it historically. Look over hundreds of years. Whenever you run into turmoil, you bring interest rates down. When things start to heat up, you bring interest rates up. That's the way it goes. Why do you bring interest rates up at all? Why not just leave them down at 0%? Think about that. People are so ridiculous when they suggest that bringing interest rates down will resolve every problem. You can't do this. You run out of ammunition when you have a crisis. You create imbalances, you create distortions and dislocations, and you will have a bigger problem later on. Yes, you can kick the can down the road, but the problem that you create will be worse. You create a Frankenstein when you do this, and that's the problem, that's the trouble that we are seeing today. 2008 was nothing, absolutely nothing to what we will face. It might not come right now in this cycle, it might be the next cycle, might be the one after, but one day it is going to be so devastating for people, they simply do not know what will hit them. Not much room to move down. This is the central bank policy rates looking at Swiss, the Fed, Bank of Japan, ECB, RBA, and the RBNZ. Now, all of these countries here are affected by the same virus, by the same disease, and that is they simply can't get away from low interest rates. It is a simple matter of fact. Everybody, all throughout this list, New Zealand and up, we are watching these countries falling into the same traps. How can they do this? How can they all do do the exact same policies and at the same time attempt to tell everybody that the economies around the world are doing fine and that they can withstand another crisis. They have no idea what they're talking about, or they're simply lying. You tell me. You know you have a problem when global government bond yields are at record lows. This has been declining for a very long time, obviously. However, it just shows you right now that we are basically suggesting that there is no value in taking on this form of debt. If you want to accept it, you're going to get a negative return. Look at this. $13 trillion in bonds have a guaranteed negative yield. You put money in, you get a negative return back guaranteed. That's the guarantee. Usually, they would say, we're going to give you 5% on your money. You keep it in here, you're good to go. However, now you're actually going to get a negative yield and they're selling out. It's crazy, but that's the way it is. And I do believe, if you look at this pie chart here, that this $13 trillion is going to continue to grow and it will be more of that pie as time goes on. We're going to watch this completely disintegrate what used to be normal. And since I touched on what's going on in Australia, I just wanted to mention this as well. Mortgage delinquencies mount as more borrowers find their home is worth less than their loan. This happened to be from May of 2019. I believe I did a video about it. But the point I wanted to get to here is simply that real estate is so integral to countries like Australia, like Canada, and even the United States and other places. We have people that have put so much into it. It is an individual's biggest investment, there is no doubt about it. You're spending $1 million in many cases to buy the average home. You have these people who will be paying it down for the next 25 to 30 years, and they are okay with it because they believe that their interest rate is very reasonable. They simply pay down, and that's the way it goes. However, along the way, things come up. They have a problem, their health issues, their spouse, their significant other, things happen, and they have to then go into debt. Well, this could come in any form. Home equity line of credit, we could have credit card, personal loans, any form of debt that comes up. Now, this will eat away at them. Many people are buying things they don't need as well, but oftentimes what we find is that people run into a scenario they didn't expect, and now suddenly they are heavily in debt. This is not as much of a problem when you have low interest rates. However, it starts to creep up, and the amount that they carry is unfortunately growing ever larger. When you take on certain forms of debt like credit card debt, it is only going to get bigger and bigger and bigger because of the serious amount of interest that is sitting on top of this. With taking on debt like this, we've got an issue specifically when this is a variable rate of interest. People will be buried by it, and that is unfortunately the case for too many. This is an article out of Bloomberg just talking about what's going on in the UK. In here, they are getting into Brexit for pretty much every possible reason. They're saying that the sun doesn't come up in the morning because of Brexit. The grass isn't growing because of Brexit. Somebody ate my lunch in the fridge at work because of Brexit. That's the way it goes. However, what you can see here is that we have a real situation that extends far beyond the UK, and that is a global economic slowdown. Now, in this article in particular, they are talking about the financial industry and the expectation that a lot of these companies are going to be firing people. You can call it laying off. You can say it's letting them go. It's firing people. They had a job and now they don't. Call it what you want. Anyway, that's it. So this article basically gets into all of that, talking about different companies, talking about different scenarios. If you want to read into it, definitely check the link in the description. But I just wanted to mention the fact that when companies face tough times, whether it's tariffs, whether it can't make profit, they will then pass that on to their consumer. The consumer can't afford it. They're not going to buy as much. No need to have certain departments. You start to increase productivity, aka fire people. And of course, this extends into the economy itself. Two things I want to mention quickly at the end here. Deutsche Bank, everybody's favorite, their restructuring costs. Think about this. To restructure Deutsche Bank, a failing institution, is going to cost up to 5 billion euro. 5 billion euro, which is basically, I think it's like a third of their market cap. And I cannot believe it, but this is what they're going to do, probably in a way, enrich those at the very, very top even further. I don't understand what they're planning on doing here, but this is is only going to make matters worse. Keep your eyes on Deutsche Bank. Do not take them off because something is seriously going on with this company. This article here is talking about Christine Lagarde. You've probably read in the news that she is looking to become the next ECB head. Many have suggested that she's going to be even more dovish, as they like to use this word, than Mario Draghi. I don't think it's possible to be any more dovish than Mario Draghi, so therefore, I simply can't agree. Now, I think it'll be a little bit more moderate, if anything. However, we are simply splitting hairs at this point. We know the direction. It is negative interest rates. We have already determined that. That's going to stay the course, and we will enter a crisis in which they do not have anything left except to print money. Get used to it because it's coming. If you found this video informative, please give me a thumbs up. Hit that like button to support this channel. I do appreciate that. If you want the financial education you were not taught in school, these two books have everything you need. All the details from A to Z, the foundation, history, the asset classes, all of it is available in the link in the description. If you want the audiobook, that's available at themoneygps.com. Wait a second, hang on, don't go anywhere. You need to watch this video. It's very important. Click on it and I will see you there.